Oh, we're going to FOD.
All right. Oh, they're ready.
Yeah, it's... We got the BBQ versus the DaNormZ. This matchup played out earlier and BBQ lost it. Do you think...
These nerds are so ready to play that, like, I actually had to rush this way to get onto commentary, and as I was putting on the headset, they had already began. Mm-hmm. Vet Tech.
This is our legendary commentary. We had to get it out for grand finals.
Oh, it's gonna happen too, baby. Mm-hmm. Frickin', so Barbecue is, he plays easily, like, 8 or even 12 of the characters moderately well. Mm-hmm. He definitely recognizes here that DaNormZ has at least his bearings with Peach and how to move around, so he went a pretty steady counter pick.
Yeah.
But DaNormZ, having not been around for, like, too long exactly, also knows full well that he had to catch up as far as the matchup knowledge goes, mm-hmm. so he's got this unlocked too.
Yeah. I'm wondering about this pick, but it could work in both their favors. Both of them can kill... Oh, that could have been scary.
Mm-hmm. I think Marth has the most advantageous, like, get-go here because mm-hmm. of how often the platforms change. He can always get a random tip or a random up tilt out of anything.
Yeah.
And Peach only really gets it because if Marth is trying to be slick and waveland off of things, the weird angle, like, lets her fix a... Or mm-hmm. choose a fixed angle to, like, float at and always hit him with an aerial.
Yeah.
Holy crap. Good clank.
I want to... This match is also really good for Marth just because of forward smash. Oh, up here, up tilt.
I almost feel really messed up seeing Marth here in Grand Finals and it not be Dust.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, it's, they play different type. BBQ is a bit more aggressive because he likes, you know, it's like, what's-his-face was saying earlier on Friendlies over there. He's like, we're playing the world's fastest fighting game, and here we are just sitting back doing nothing.
Mm-hmm.
That's how BBQ feels a lot.
That was slick. Yeah, that was the absolute, like...
Last frame.
Mm-hmm. That you could get that tipper without him getting the ledge. Or not even tipper, but tickler.
Oh. The spacing, the forward airs. His favorite move. Oh. This is bad. Yep. He can still recover, but it's still gonna be... Ooh, he dropped it early. Yep, there it is.
Dude is thirsty for that $5 we offer here at Byte Club.
Never... I don't know, man. $5, that's Wendy's money right there.
Yo, you're not wrong!
That's a 4 for 4.
Holy crap. That was strong. Is he gonna bubble? Oh, I thought he was gonna bubble into 69.
Double D's gonna hate me for this one, but is that our sponsor's Wendy's?
Wendy's, though!
Did you hear about what happened at,
Melee 8?
Melee Haven.
Melee Haven 8 about Jimmy John's?
Yeah, I was pulling out the Jimmy John's, and Double D was mad about it. He's like, bro, we could get sued.
No, yeah, dude, I saw it hit the screen for a second. Because, I mean, I was cutting through the videos.
Yeah.
So I saw it hit the screen for a second.
And you were like, what is going on? Man, I wish I was so... We're not getting paid for any of that, so it's not like we couldn't actually get sued. Maybe if we get bigger, but, like, I don't know. It'd be funny, though, to actually have, like, a sponsor. Because I would just go, oh, no.
I'll probably get something, well, more like a fast food chain to, like, help advertise, like, in turn.
Mm-hmm. I mean,
we give them some business cards, they give us some coupons.
I mean, Byte Club kind of is like a sponsor, but it's the venue, so it's not, like, I don't know. It's not really the same.
Neither of them are feeling too hot about being in each other's face.
No.
A lot of this game has been more, hit and run, juked out ant.
Oh. If you would have teched that, that would have changed everything. Oh.
My favorite part about that was he tried to cover him going high, mm-hmm. so he actually threw it up. But then it became convenient to re-grab it, so he threw it down.
I didn't catch that far. I caught the turnip hitting him and him dying.
Dude, it was secret.
Oh no! Don't do it, BBQ. Come on. Responsible, Cody.
I'm only gonna ruin this being a meme with myself because every time I've been in commentary, I've said it. But that part that DaNormZ did is definitely going into combo video.
When's the combo video coming out? You got a release date yet?
No, dude. The combo video. When the combo gets further, you'll see the end of the combo.
No.
That wasn't a very happy ending.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see if he's gonna.
Whoa! Hold on. If DaNormZ is doing good over here, let's pay a little bit of respect, okay? And properize his name. His name is DaNormZ with a capital Z.
I didn't catch that when I went over on the bracket. I was trying to do it. Oh no, the puff. This matchup is difficult for both of them, but like it's still in Jig's favor. It's just so slow.
That last thing that I said about that match as it was ending, it's just a hit and run kind of race. This is gonna really bring that to life. This is gonna be hit and run all over the place.
This isn't Barbecue's normal place now. I know he's feeling some salt. Look at his positioning right now. Look what he's doing.
No, yeah, he's staying away. He's making it out to be that DaNormZ needs a hiccup. DaNormZ needs a hiccup for Barbecue to even so much as do damage to him.
Mm-hmm. I don't know about you, but I want to see him time him out. I want to see Barbecue time DaNormZ out.
I don't want to see it. I wouldn't mind. In fact,
I think it would be funny.
Yeah, if we can bring something like that high level of
I think he's going,
you know, thirst for the game. Mm-hmm. I hope so.
Oh, I hope so too. Look at him go. What is Peach gonna do?
Okay, assuming that that's not the plan,
mm-hmm.
that's definitely like a bleak consideration.
Mm-hmm. See, I know that you actually you questioned if they should switch it to 6 minutes, and I was actually not in favor for it.
Mm-hmm.
Me and Knight actually had different opinions, but both of them were correct. He felt like with slower characters were forced to engage and had no game plan. Mm-hmm. Well, I felt it was the opposite way. I felt like with less time, slower characters like, you know, Peach, Jigglypuff, don't have to wait out as long to time someone out.
Yes.
They only have to deal with 6 minutes instead of 8, and that it puts a lot more stress on the faster player to actually just mess up.
Yeah, like, exactly.
It goes both ways. I feel like, if the slow character's behind, then, like, they're screwed, but, like...
I'm all behind the 6 minute change, but simply, of course, we can't do it if not everyone else wants to do it.
Mm-hmm.
I think in general it would actually be great for us, because on top of all the things that you mentioned, it would generally just make us have to play faster, smarter, mm-hmm. and we need more things like that actually condition us to it rather than fall into habitual patterns.
See, I feel both ways about it. I do agree that like it would be nice seeing it, but people have more playstyles than just fast.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, like, look at one example I wanted to bring out, but I was at work at the time when you guys were talking about it, was Chudat versus Hugs when he went so when he got the two kills of Sopo and got into Evo,
mm-hmm.
like the top 8 in Evo. That match actually went until a minute 30.
You're not wrong. Yeah.
And like if we switched to 6 minutes, that legendary match would have never finished like that. That mm-hmm. match was just so funny to watch. Oh no. But we're good though. So what do you think Peach should do in this? He is going to
I had a handful of ideas, and as syllables for them began to structure themselves into sentences, it all also hit the ground and crashed. I have not a faint clue what Peach can do here that isn't just gonna, like, you know, be churning butter.
Mm-hmm.
Every little hit that Peach does is gonna deal roughly the same kind of base knockback against Puff. Like, every hit from 0 to 70 is just gonna send her to the other side of the stage. Not exactly like that, but, like, there's no comboing this character like this, and not with Peach's speed.
Right.
The only way you can have any kind of a hand here is to have turnips out nonstop, and trying to bait Jiggs' movement into it. Like, I think down there on the platform, it probably would have worked out in her favor, seeing that the Jiggs likes to go about half triangle lately. Maybe throw the turnip up.
4 minutes, 10 seconds in, we got our third kill. Oh, man.
Hey, I respect it. If they got the guts to do it, mm-hmm. then they should do it.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm not against this.
I mean, I would blatantly be wobbling you if I was any good at it.
Is this game one?
No.
This
two. This is game two.
Anime was a mistake.
Anime really was a mistake, to be honest.
I'm catching bleach over here on my peripheral. Gotta not do that.
I really want to see the timeout.
I just started the series.
It's pretty good. Bleach is okay. I'm on 87 right now. You're a machine.
Like, I can't wait to
I think you could have got him with a sneaky uppie right there.
Maybe. But, like, that would have left him open.
It would have been awesome. What do you think? Okay, let's just go ahead and sell it short, just to, like, fast forward ourselves 2 minutes. Barbecue wins this.
Yeah.
Either on the time.
You can tell. You can see the salt.
Either on the timeout if necessary, otherwisingly by milking the stock out of them, because this is going to be, Simply Puff does not have this in, or Peach does not have this in her to take this much damage and this much percent and all these trades on Jigs in 2 minutes with one stock. What's the third game gonna be like? Because
it depends. Knowing Barbecue, he's probably gonna, he has two mind thoughts sets here. Stay Jigs because he's mad, switch characters because he just can't stay a same character multiple times.
Mm-hmm.
If he stays Jigs, then like Peach is forced to take him to like Yoshi's story just because the counter taunt. He's forced to take him to Yoshi just because he needs a way to get in on this character, this tongue character. But like, if you take him to Yoshi's, then Peach is also dying earlier too, so it goes both ways.
Exactly. If taken to Yoshi's, I feel like the game plan turns a little bit more from strictly camping him out to luring him into getting rested.
I wanted to see the timeout real bad.
That was absolutely brutal. I don't know how I feel about that being at my venue.
6.5 minutes. Let's see if he's able to stay the character. If nothing else, if he decides not to stick with Jigs, then he's gotten his head enough to, like, change it.
He can waste possibly this game not going Jigs, trying to go something else. If he goes another, like, one of his competitive bronzer characters, Mario or Ganon, he can probably get into Norm's head, putting it into the third game is already out of his favor.
I don't see him going Mario. I don't see him going Mario. That man, I don't know if...
No, I know I said Mario, but... I lied.
It's like, you know, it's one of his signature characters. Yep, I figured. This gets into his head real bad.
This is blatantly,
Oh, Marth again. Alright.
Fair. We like that. Oh, and then you go into Yoshi's anyways.
Yeah. Now that, DaNormZ is not happy. I wouldn't have been happy about that last match either, but, like, I'm a bit of a memer, so I would have been, an early stock, a zero to death. And he died at 69.
For real! Combo video. I can feel DaNormZ's passion channeled through Peach. That down smash looks like it's moving more aggressive and faster than I've ever seen it.
Oh. I want to see them use it. Go Mr. Saturn. Dude, get that anime titty out of here. This is purely a non-weeaboo stream.
Non-weeaboo, thoroughly Christian. Good mother.
This is...
The two or three events that Barbecue has come out to for us, I think he's taken first at two of them. Definitely some substantial points for him on our PR that we're launching in June.
Man. If I wasn't so inconsistent, I feel like I would place at least within, within like either, what does it go up to, 12?
We're doing it to 12, yeah.
Alright, I feel like if I was just...
To 12 with three or four honorable mentions.
Alright, if I wasn't so inconsistent, I feel like I could definitely be anywhere from like 12 to maybe 7.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe even higher, but like I don't want to...
I haven't so much as roughed up even the numbers a little bit right now, but I wouldn't doubt that you're probably easily right there on the top 12 somewhere. I mean, we have only about a consistent base of players, something like 20 people that show up in general. Mm. It's just a matter of where, how far down the line are you?
Yeah.
No. What?
The down throw forward smash is scary.
That look... God, that looked akin to, like, you know, a scripted chess match that you're playing against your nephew.
Mm. So, I kind of want to see the Jigglypuff come out again and see if he can form, see if he can time him out again. I want to see it just because I'm a meme lord, but like,
I don't think it's coming out. Yeah, you're not allowed to request something like that and not condescend yourself by admitting that you're a meme lord. Because I'm just thinking about that happening, and I'm like,
I want to see him pull out the Yoshi. He has one too. Oh, I didn't expect it, but okay. Ganon? Yeah, this
please, please Ganon, please Ganon, please Ganon, or not Link. Ganon.
Yep, there it is. And
I wouldn't be surprised if
Battlefield, it's going Battlefield, they said it earlier.
I wouldn't be surprised if Cody, like, he's just holding him in longer, just getting, like, more of a wrap around him, you know? His toggling of all the characters is just another mind game.
After this is over, you need to go back and watch this match. Imagine your barbecue and just, like, think about what's going on in his head. Look at his movements. Look at him taunting. You can tell something's going on. And he's trying to make some type of statement. Also, he's coming from losers. So any mind games he can come right now, he's going to have to pull it through another few games. But, like, that's a lot of melee to sit down and just keep a straight head in, so.
Mm-hmm. Who would put BBQ in losers? DaNormZ even did. Okay. Yeah.
See, DaNormZ put him in losers, so this is why he's playing like this. It's the only one. There's only a few people who actually enjoy playing like this. I mean, unless you're doing it to be a meme lord like he is right now. The only people who really enjoy doing this is like HBox, MacD, Armada, and like Mewtwo King. Mewtwo King actually plays a lot like how BBQ is playing right now, but like you wouldn't know just because this stuff looks so cool.
I would say the only reason that they actually enjoy it too is just it means that they can assure the win and stress out the foe. Mm-hmm. I often take a great deal of pleasure in like a video game or something when I know that the foe against me is having a hard time. That duck.
Oh no, I kind of feel the same way. I feel more so. I enjoy matches that are actually closer. Like, it really just depends on how much of a hard time they're having, I guess. Like, it feels good to force stock someone, yeah, but, like, if it's their first time playing Melee, then you do feel kind of bad. I felt like that, too. I force stocked a guy earlier, like, a few weeks ago when I was playing someone.
One of the kids?
Not a kid. Someone who was just playing Melee for the first time. I force stocked him, and I felt bad because it was his first time playing it, but, like, yeah. But at the same time, it was like, they don't know what to do against it. It's so scary to play Melee for your first time especially against the Fox. And
my highest hopes are really for Peach pulling out a Bomb-Omb.
It would be funny.
And just popping this balloon.
I haven't actually been paying that much attention to the game, but I did notice that he's playing a bit more aggressive than that first time. A bit more like the barbecue style, we all know.
Mm-hmm. DaNormZ is meeting up on a strategy that was more beneficial to the previous play of Puff, but he's using a hell of a lot more turnips, at least he was in this match so far. I keep wondering why Peach isn't pulling out a turnip in midair, and then I remember that I've been playing too much Brawl Minus.
Wrong game. It's not even like a Brawl mod, too.
I didn't say I was smart.
Alright. Hey, man. You're only as dumb as you make yourself out to be. You can TL much better than like anyone here. So you got the brains and other things.
Fair, fair.
Like, I can't tell you a thing about a car, but you get me in some Melee and I can tell you like just random stats that no one really knows for some reason.
Mm-hmm. Fair.
Like, like how Roy has like only a few spikes and one of them is his up smash.
I'm upset.
I know. His down air barely spikes. You have to get, like, the most perfect angle for it.
And I'm confident you're not lying either. That's wrong.
Mm-hmm. And you, like, it's, I think it's only the first hit of it, too. It's either, like, the first or the last hit. So to even use it effectively, you'd have to space it perfectly.
We're headed to the 4-minute mark.
Oh. I don't know. I'm sure BBQ can hear me right now. And
one.
I could do something that could get him on his edge. I could talk about how I believe Pichu should be higher on the tier list.
Don't do that. That is way too meta.
I think he's better than Roy, though. I do agree. I do think he's better than Roy.
I don't disagree, but I mean, that's just so meta getting in his head like that while we're over here.
I'm not going to. I'll save that commentary for another time. I'm sure I've done it before, but I'm just going to leave it there.
So, with half the time passed, our stats are 3 on Jigs, 1 on Peach. This, I can't begin to imagine how DaNormZ feels right now. I mean, I bet he feels strong.
Yeah. Oh, I'm hungry. I'm still hungry from the earlier.
Yeah. Did you eat?
Last time I ate was at 2 o'clock. But, like, that was the only time I ate. And I shared my food with, like, a bunch of high schoolers.
Why? What even?
I was hanging out with some of my high school friends, and I brought my McDonald's meal and, like, some chicken nuggets to go and pass out. And
you're a nice, freaking stupid nerd. Now you're hungry because you gave food to ingrates.
I wasn't full per se after eating, but it's not like I was hungry afterwards. I was to the point where I was like, okay, I'm satisfied.
Satiated.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Is it gonna come back?
Okay, this can very well still be something.
Yeah, I mean, at the same time, he could just still camp him out like he was in that one game.
Mm-hmm. I feel like this deep into the game, BBQ is half pressured to make better decisions sooner, simply to not have to face getting trades and probably near to equal percentage. Yeah. So right now, he just needs to deal as many light hits rapidly as he can to build up the percent or get him off the stage. He's happy with where he's at. He doesn't need to do anything more than just keep evading.
I want to see this go into a bracket reset. Oh, yep, bracket reset. Let's go. I want to see it go into this.
Bracket reset.
Here, I had a. Last time I was here, I got a monster, and I told she's like, I'm just gonna put it on your tab for whenever you pay, and I forgot to pay her, so I paid for it today, and then paid for my new monster.
Oh, with actual money.
Mm-hmm.
Actual money, yeah, here at Byte Club.
I was, I gotta support this small business, gotta keep it going.
Exactly. Alright, here in the Grand Finals Bracket Reset, BBQ versus DaNormZ.
Back to Puff. What do you think about drink? Sure, thank you. What do you think about this matchup, on this map?
This is probably the, like, weirdest and stalest, but active that this whole, like, set between them has been. Without platforms, where is he to run to? He has to wall them out. He has to be way more aggressive than before. He has nowhere to run.
Unless
he's just gonna, like, back and forthingly retreat to each edge and try doing that.
Just gotta keep doing that. Yeah, with no platforms to escape to, he can't really run away, but at the same time. Okay. But at the same time, Puff can't do it. Peach can't really get in as easily either without the platforms. You can't. It's hard for her to get past the wall of pain.
Yeah, there are less games that each of them are even, like, allowed to consider playing on each other here.
I don't want to see this become a thing. But what do you think about what if Grand Finals Reset was a best of three instead of a best of five? I've always wondered about what would happen. I don't want to see it stitched to that, but I wonder.
Like, once the bracket gets reset, the second set played becomes a 2 out of 3 opposed to a 3 out of 5.
I've wondered about that.
Like, I actually don't exactly disagree with that formula. I feel like people would want it to be longer just because of how close it is to the end, being literally the end.
Yeah.
But that does sound like a very interesting, like, worthwhile format to go to.
We just have to work harder.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Because then now they have, like, less room to mess up.
Then again, you would have the thing where players can ban their stages that they don't want to play on, and with the best of three that you get. So, I don't know. It goes both ways. I'd like to see it as experimented, but I don't think it should be the standard.
There you go. That's the suck.
Mm. Why are you laying apart from turnips?
Pop it up.
So I can't wait. After this, I'm probably going to go hang out with BBQ afterwards, get some food. We're going to go and talk about how shit I am at this game and how good he is.
Fuck yeah!
It's the...
No. You're better than me!
Yeah, I got knocked out right away.
Are you serious?
Nah, no. Like, I fought two Marths, and the first Marth was Crouton, and Crouton pulled it through towards the end. And the second time I lost against I don't remember his name, but the dude.
AKA.
Yeah, AKA. Dude, know what he knew what he was doing. Was that Stitch? My blind or is that Stitch face? It's kind of hard to tell.
It's a Stitch.
That's scary for Jigs, especially at this percent. It's scary just in general, but like.
He's trying to. Oh.
He just lost. Yeah, it was probably a good idea. He wasn't going to let him do it.
Yeah, exactly. So investing in it was really just kind of like inviting himself to trip in a hole.
Mm-hmm. You know what I love that Fox can do? If you grab the Stitch, you can do Shine into Turnip Throw, and it's a true combo because she'll still be stuck in our. She'll still be stuck in the hit lap stun. But, you know, it requires the player to have technical skill. Because you're trying to. You have to do, like, the immediate Shine, the immediate Wave Dash. Not even Wave Dash, just jump out of it and throw. And if you're a few frames off, she won't have time to shield.
Damn.
Not like I see them expecting that, but, like, it's a thing. Oh. I don't know if that was on purpose, but
that was
smart.
Beautiful.
That was beautiful.
Mm-hmm. I love the coverage of throwing the turnip up and then, like, walking past it. That way he can't get behind you.
Mm-hmm. I'm just glad DaNormZ hasn't taken him to Dreamland. That's probably the best part about this whole thing is that he did not do it. It's mm-hmm. not. Oh, another Mr. Saturn.
Because as good as it would be for Peach, it does not make the job any easier still. It makes it so Peach will live longer, but this just means there's more space for Puff to resort to time him out.
Mm-hmm. Man, this is going to be a long... This is going to be a long clip. Long two clips.
Yeah, I definitely already cut the other one because it was already at, I think, 15 minutes or so.
Do you plan on putting them together since it is still the same match, or...?
That would probably be best, yeah.
Yeah. Because I know a lot of... Oh, man, that he lost his kill there.
A lot of other places definitely still put bracket resets together on the same VOD. Yeah, definitely. I was half struggling with the idea, but I'm glad you proposed it.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, I was just going to do it and not ask anybody.
You saw he was charging an up smash. It was the next hit that got the kill. And
when dash attack can almost take it.
There it is. Oh, it's not.
Preemptive?
I mean, why not, though? Backer.
I call him preemptive, but look what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, come on. Don't. Mm-hmm. Don't lose your way.
No taunt. No taunt on the game.
My what isn't glowing?
Oh, yeah, your headset's not glowing. Check
my
volume? Yeah, you're fine.
Yeah.
I don't know why they're not glowing.
Yours is glowing.
No, it's not.
It is.
It is? Oh, yeah. I just turned it off. Yeah, I see your mic is glowing, though, so we're good.
I want my headset to glow!
Yes, it does. You gotta turn it on.
How do I do that?
There's a light button on there somewhere. On the other side. Right down here. One of these two. Back to XP.
Wow, granted I can't see it. That's actually really lame. I'm turning that off.
Why?
I want to be able to see it.
Yeah, we're back to FD. It's probably Peach's best chance. Either FD or Yoshi's. I mean, we talked about the Yoshi pick earlier.
This is one of these matches that, hey. This is one of those matches that DaNormZ needed about right now in his gaming career. Because...
Mm-hmm.
Say this is as hard as it gets before it being but before it's a matter of him getting outplayed by someone who has like much higher execution ceiling than him. This is more like, okay, so hey, there's this whole part of patience and avoidance and campiness that that you guys aren't even like so much as trinkled to yet.
DaNormZ had so much luck this set. Oh, he just wasted it. He's had so much luck, though. He's gotten two Mr. Saturns, two Stitch Faces, maybe even three Stitch Faces, I don't remember.
Maybe.
Maybe. You can tell the norm's not happy about it. There it is. Oh, nice.
Steak.
Looking like Fox with the random up ears killing.
Right.
Although it's... Oh. Oh, no. You can hear him yell. Uptilt is so crazy against floaties at early percents. It leads into rest if they don't DI away.
Mm-hmm.
And even if they DI away, you can do pound, and if they DI in for that,
then they're just
rest.
Exactly, then they just sign themselves up for it. Mm-hmm. They fell right in place on top of you for it. Oh no, make something out of this. Oh.
Yeah, he's not happy.
I understand it.
Do you think we're going to see a change of character? I kind of want to see it, but I don't know if he actually has anyone that can deal with Puff.
I've been playing with the norm since he started playing, and I think he kind of basically relatively knows most of the main cast and probably would second either Fox or Captain Falcon, and I definitely haven't seen him pull anyone but Peach and Moons, dude. So if he pulls out anyone, it'd be kind of like a hopeful last whim. He's going to remain Peach, and laters.
Right, all right. He finally has a character that can catch up. You think I should do the money match with the norm right away after this?
Yes.
Okay. Although I still need the money, which is the problem. It is nice though that we're finally getting a change of pace. It's gonna be a bit harder to time them out. Still possible, don't get me wrong, but oh no.
Hey, I'm good for him going whatever route he wants to take in this.
I do like that he's playing safe, because that's what you have to do against Puff, but you play too safe, then Puff will have center stage, which is what she wants.
Mm-hmm.
You watch Hungry Box, he will control center stage like a lot of, or like no one's business. Better he'll sit on a sit on a corner, but we're not talking about that. That jab, I would have loved to see an up smash afterwards. That's what you, it popped him up just high enough. See, you could have done it again there.
In a lot of these movements, notice that it looks like DaNormZ is kind of coming in on him to weave out of him, right? To like juke. He's trying to like juke him out of a move, make him think that he was going to do something, and then he does nothing. Getting him conditioned to a little bit of like a different approach on Fox, and then suddenly just landing some banhammers on him.
Norm's looking like Armada. Can't deal with Puff with Peach switching over to Fox. Oh, how did that miss?
No!
You can't really survive that much.
That's too funny that got him anyways.
DaNormZ cocky. He's being super cocky right now. If DaNormZ wins this match, then we already know what's gonna happen. If he stays Fox, then he's in for not a good time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. That's the next level. Is player cams.
Another up smash, but it's too low for that. Oh man, I love Fox. Back
here.
Mm-hmm.
Seeing their faces when they do it.
And then you see it on YouTube too.
Right. I think it's for being
here.
Mm-hmm. Oh man. Don't get me wrong, BBQ is not winning this match at the moment, but it's still funny watching him just dictate the flow of the game. Wait. Can't be. There's no reason for you to be aggressive towards the ledge.
Nothing about any of our friends, but I feel like even if our other friends from our Grand Haven area or Miles had made it here, mm-hmm. that this would probably still be Grand Finals.
Yep. All right. I know, Barbecue, I know you have like a huge lead right now, but you still gotta realize like you are in tournament right now. This will affect your random small town PR ranking. There it is.
Holy crap!
You know.
Yeah, this one's crazy. Oh!
He was going for a crazy rest setup. I knew exactly what he was doing there.
Yeah. That was a very Marvel combo resty. This could be the tournament stock. Clear.
That
Clear.
Becker's not gonna finish this dog off, not on this map. And not unless it's closer to the edge.
Yeah, you gotta get him off the edge. The ceiling here is real high.
No, it's pretty good.
What are you doing? Alright, well, all right. This is it.
I certainly believe he wanted forward smash, or up smash.
I believe it. Oh.
Make it clean, make it clean. Mr. Clean.
That's a run-up up smash right there. It's at that percent, at 117, if my brain is in it, you do down throw, and you tech chase and hit with the up smash.
Because
at that percent, you can't get the up throw up air unless they're being dumb. Especially if you're on a platform.
Oh!
There's no. Yep. This is it.
Come on.